In this video, I'm going to show you how you can submit an assignment in your Google Classroom. We will be submitting two types of assignment, a quiz and an essay assignment, where you have to write an essay about any topic. But when you learn this process, you will understand that actually you have many options to submit an assignment. You can submit a Word document, a Google document, any file, or you can even submit a link. And I will show you all this process step by step. But before I start, for someone who don't know me, my name is Tahir. Welcome to my channel. And if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. And now let us start. So to log into your Google Classroom, you just type classroom.google.com in your browser. Then you click on this plus sign and then you click on join class. Now you enter the code which your teacher has provided to you in this area. Then this join will enable and you click on join and you will join the class. And because I have already joined this class as a student, so I'm going to cancel this. Then you will see this page. Now in order to check your assignments, you first click the name of the class and now you have this classwork tab. Click on that. Now on the left hand side, you have this all topics. Now these topics are normally folders in Google Classroom and this is a folder. So let us pretend that this is your week one of this class, which starts from this date up to this date. So your teacher has created this folder for you, which is known as topic. So currently we only have one topic, and in this folder for week one, you have two assignments. One is to write an essay and the other is a quiz assignment. And now today we are going to submit these two assignments. So first let's start with a quiz because it is more simpler to submit. So I click on this assignment and then I will see Google Forms here, because all quiz assignments, which is one of the types of assignments available in Google Classroom, essentially we get a Google Form. And exponents is the title of this assignment. So this assignment is probably about exponents. So let us first do this. So I click on this assignment's title and now I get this Google form. And in this assignment, there are two questions only, but this is just to show you. You could have many more questions, but the process will be the same. So the first question, if x square is 4, what's the value of x? So 2 is the correct value. And now the second question is, what is an alternative way of writing the following expression, which is cube root of x? Now the correct answer is C, x raised to the power 1 divided by 3. But let us choose a wrong answer to show you what happens if you select a wrong answer. So I'm going to select a wrong answer here and I click on submit. And now I see this message, response submitted. And my teacher has allowed me to view the score, so I can straight away view my score. And as you can see that I have got 2 out of 4 marks in this assignment. My first question was correct and second was wrong. And this is my answer, which is wrong. And this is the correct answer. So now our first assignment has been submitted. So I can simply close this tab because it opens in a new tab. I can also close this tab and now I am again in my topic folder. And now I click on this first assignment. And first I would like to see the rubrics. And what are rubrics? Rubrics are some extra instructions given by your teacher, which will explain to you how you can get marks. These are general instructions for making this assignment, but rubrics are specific instructions showing you how are you going to get marks in this assignment. So therefore I click on this rubrics, and in this area I can see that I have 3 rubrics here. The first is accuracy of information, and if I present accurate information I will get 2 points, and if there are some minor inaccuracies I will get 1 point. Then for next 2 points, my teacher has explained to me that this is the situation where you are going to get 2 points and this is the situation where you are going to get 1 point. Now, the third rubric is about critical thinking, and this rubric has 3 levels. And if I show excellent critical thinking, I will get 6 points. If my assignment shows a good level of critical thinking, I will get 3 points. Or if it's just an acceptable level, I will get 2 points. So in this way, I might get 6, 2 and 2, making it 10 out of 10. or any portion of that. So rubrics are very important that you first have a look at the rubrics before doing the assignment. Now I can close this by, clicking on this cross sign. And now I click on view assignment. And in this case, I'm going to create my assignment in a Google document. So I click on this add or create. So I click on that. And now as you can see that I have many options. I can submit from my Google Drive. I can submit a simple link. I can attach a file, or I can straight away create a Google document or Google slide or sheet, because there could be many types of assignment. One assignment could be where you have to make a spreadsheet. So I have many options. So I can straight away create a Google document from within my Google Classroom. So I click on this docs, and now it's creating a Google document for me. And now as you can see that a Google document has been created, and it shows the title of the essay. And now I can write some essay here. And of course you will be writing a full essay here, but this is just to demonstrate. So this is my essay. And now I have this button here, which normally is not present until you are submitting an assignment in your Google Classroom. And it shows me turn in. So this is the first step of submitting your assignment if you are creating it in your Google document, which is the most easiest way to create assignments for Google Classroom. So I click on turn in. It will open a new tab, and it will show me this message that turn in your work. And it also shows me that there will be an attachment with my assignment, which will be submitted. And I click on turn in. And now my assignment has been submitted. I can also unsubmit this assignment. And if I do this and I click on unsubmit, I will get this message. And if I again click on unsubmit, my assignment will be unsubmitted, and I can even delete this. And now I am again back to my initial position. Although you don't have to do this, because you can modify your assignment anytime. But if you want to delete for some reason, you can even delete your assignment in your Google Classroom. So this was a tutorial about how to submit an assignment in Google Classroom. And I have shown you two different assignments, a quiz and an essay. So I hope that you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.